welcome to my kachina. Never gets old. Today we're going to do some garlic bread, but not just any garlic bread, it's going to be cheese stuffed garlic bread. So before we start, let's commence with the old vino, a bit of Italiano going on in here. So it's not Italian, it's from Chile, but I don't think anyone minds. Cheers. Right, it's really easy. We've got some bread flour in here, add some salt and some yeast. And now I just need 550 mils of warm water. Perfect. So in that goes. And now just bring your dough together. Fona, did you adjust the amount of water for the amount of flour? Lola's ruined it! And for once, it wasn't me! We'll be back in a minute, scrap that. And we're back, Lola's weighed it all again. Yeast going in, salt. Cue dough related puns, you donut. So the right amount of water this time, which is 275. To bring it together. I kind of like use my bit, a big bit of dough to get the small bits on. There it goes. Right. If it feels a bit sticky, don't be tempted to add more flour. Lots of different ways of kneading. Everyone's got different methods. So you can do stretch and tear, which is kind of like this, you develop the gluten like this, or you can do slapping the dough. So you need to knead it for about 5 minutes until it feels nice and springy and elastic. So there we go. Oh, nearly lost my dough. Look at that. So I'm going to put this into a bowl and let it prove for 40 minutes, and then we'll come back when it's doubled in size. So while our dough's proving, we're going to make some lovely garlic butter. I've got some butter here and just a few cloves of garlic. Oh, it's really nice, isn't it, with the birds? We should have pre-skinned the garlic cloves. Right, so just going to crush these in. Oh! we're so professional in here. There it is. So I'm just going to microwave this until the butter has melted. Oh, look at that, steamy butter. And now I'm just going to add some basil into there. Hopefully you could drink it. I could actually. So there we go, that's all ready. So now I'm going to go on to my second stage of dough. Look at that, so it's kind of doubled in size. But first I'm going to prep my tin. So this is a really nice way of doing this garlic bread. I'm going to use a cake tin. So what I'm going to do, brush the cake tin with some garlic butter. I'm going to scatter in some polenta, and this will make the kind of the bottom of the... I'm going to scatter in the polenta, and that's going to make the bottom of the garlic bread really, really crunchy, and it'll also come out of the tin nice and easily. So that's ready. So now I'm going to split it into little dough balls. So I want them all to be about the same size, because this is actually going to be a really, not only is it going to be delicious, but it's going to be a really pretty arrangement of dough balls. So just section it into 50 gram balls. I'm going to weigh it as well, just because I want them all to be a nice similar size. Oh, that's only 37. 50, it's really satisfying when you biff it on there and it's exactly the weight you want. What we're gonna do now is get stuffing. Just kind of lift up and tuck in like that. Pop a little dent in there. That's the home for the cheese. In goes the cheese, and then just gather it up over the cheese. Pinch it together and just pop that back into the tin. So I'm leaving a little bit of space in between because they are going to expand. So I'm just going to tuck that one in there. So there we go, I'm going to pop them to proof and we'll come back and biff them in the oven when they've got all big. Our dough has risen nicely and now it's time to bake it. So now we're going to add some more of that lovely garlic butter and just brush it really generously all over my balls. Get it all down in the old crevices there. So now I'm going to put it in the oven at 190 for 20 minutes, then we'll take it out and brush it again and put it in for another 5. It's garlic butter time. Let's give it an extra brush. Look at that. It looks like a little tortoise. It's a garlic bread tortoise. Pop that back in the oven to bake it off. And then we'll be back when it's ready and we'll give it an extra bit of brushing. But, oh, that's gonna be amazing. It's beeping. Oh, it smells so good. Look at that. Listen to that. Okay, the moment of truth. I'm so excited. Oh, is it all drippy and lovely and garlic buttery? Look! Look at that, look at it. I'm so happy with this. It looks really pretty, which I love. It smells amazing and it's gonna taste good. Let's put it to the test. Like this. Oh, look at it. Oh, oh yes, look. Oh my God, I'm doing it slowly. I don't wanna ruin the chip. They're making me happy. I'm gonna eat this, let's test it. Get all that cheese in there. Oh my God. It's wonderful. It's a bit awkward when you eat on camera, isn't it? Right, well, that's amazing. You've got to make this. Everything you need to create the recipe is just down there. I hope you enjoyed the video and come back soon for more.